Now, the way in which we have derived is usually followed in chemical engineering books, transfer phenomena books. If you look at fluid mechanics books, the same derivation is done, of course, end result cannot change, but in a slightly different way. So, for you to enable to understand from fluid mechanics book, what we will do is derive in that particular way also. Small steps, some steps are different, end result is same. Okay. Let us do that. I illustrate only for the x direction, so that you can understand for the directions. Now, we said the rate of flow of total mass entering at x equal to rho v x evaluated at x into delta y delta z. Okay. That is what is shown here. Okay. This diagram is our earlier representation. The diagram shown here, the control volume shown here is the new representation. Okay. Now, this is what, this is how we express the total mass entering, and that is what is shown here. Okay. The way in which it is done is, this vertical bar and x are not usually shown, it is just written as rho v x, implication is that it is evaluated at x. Okay. So, the vertical bar x are not shown, and that is the representation shown here. Physical significance is same, representation is slightly different. Okay. 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 Now, rate of flow of total mass leaving at x plus delta x, this is where a little more difference comes in terms of representation. Okay. The way in which we have represented is rho v x evaluated x plus delta x multiplied by delta y delta z. Okay. What is done in this fluid mechanics, the fluid mechanics books is that this is rho v x evaluated x plus delta x is represented in terms of Taylor series. Taylor series about rho v x or at position x. So, we expand rho v x at x plus delta x in terms of Taylor series about rho v x at x. How do you do that? Rho v x, of course, as I told you, we do not represent bar and x, and then the first derivative, of course, partial derivative multiplied by delta x, second derivative multiplied by delta x squared by 2, etcetera, multiplied by delta y delta z. So, this instead of writing this way, expand in Taylor series. Okay. Let us see further how do we proceed. Now, in the derivation we have seen, we are dividing by delta x, delta y, delta z, and then we shrink the control volume, meaning that delta x tend to 0, delta y tend to 0, delta z tend to 0. So, what will happen if you divide this expression by delta x, delta y, delta y, delta z will cancel out, then you will have delta x. Okay. Now, terms which have delta x squared and higher, here delta x, if you divide by delta x, for the delta x squared term, delta x will remain, then delta x squared will remain, and then when you take delta x tending 0, all those terms will not contribute. So, which means that only the first two terms will contribute. So, the way in which is written is neglecting second and higher order terms. Why is that? You divide by delta x, delta by delta z, in all other higher order terms, second higher order terms, delta x will remain. We are going to shrink and then say delta x tending to 0. So, all those terms will not contribute. So, we neglect second and higher order terms and write the rate of mass leaving at x plus delta x as only the first two terms, of course, multiply by area. Okay. And that is what is shown here on the right side face. Okay. Look at this representation, look at this representation. Okay. Now, what is a net rate of flow of total mass out minus in, whatever flow leaving minus entering. So, this particular expression and then minus expression multiplied by delta y delta z. So, rho v x cancels out, we are left with dou by dou x of rho v x, we divide by delta x delta y delta z, and then result in our same expression as you have got earlier. This is what we are saying. Of course, you can extend to other terms as well and obtain this same differential form of total mass balance equation. Okay. So, this is what you will find in fluid mechanics books. Other small variant is that we took x, y, z at one corner, they take in the center of the control volume. So, here you will have delta x by 2, here you will have the same expression with minus delta x by 2, etcetera. So, those are other variants, but I have shown one variant here, so that you can follow other variants as well. Okay. Okay. So, let us proceed further. So, what are the steps in deriving conservation equation? Okay, I would say this is a very important slide in the sense that we have arrived at a recipe of deriving conservation equations. And because it is mass balance, it is what is easier to for us to follow. We keep this in mind, we can extend this to other conservation equations as well. Okay. So, what are the steps? First is we started with the law of physics, okay, and then we applied the Reynolds transport theorem, and then we took considered coincident system and control volume, okay, and then we arrived at the integral balance equation. Okay. I have not used here mass, momentum, anything, because this is applicable for all the conservation equations. Okay. And then we applied the integral balance for a small fixed control volume, okay, and then we shrink the volume to a point, resulting in a differential balance equation. Okay. So, these steps are universal across derivation of all the conservation equations. So, let us repeat that, starting with the law of physics, applying the Reynolds transport theorem, we said that is the use of Reynolds transport theorem, going from system to control volume, and then we consider the system and control volume to be coincident and we get integral balance equation. Use that as starting point, apply that for a small control volume, shrink the control volume to a point, resulting in a differential balance equation. Okay, so, let us look at the physical significance of the terms in the differential total mass balance equation. By this time, it should be clear the way in which you have wrote down the different terms. So, okay, this is the expanded form, and here you have the in terms of vectorial notation. Slowly can get used to the vectorial form as well, very nice representation. Okay. Now, we have two, I would say two terms, one is the variation of the time term and other is the net mass flow rate leaving term. Okay. So, let us look at significance. The first term represents time rate of change of mass per unit volume. Second term significance is that net rate of flow of mass out by convection per unit volume. If you observe, the significance of the terms are same as that of integral balance. Obviously, it cannot change. We have started from there. So, significance should be same, but in what way it is different? There it was just time rate of change of mass, but it is here it is per unit volume. Remember, we divided by delta x, delta y, delta z. So, this tells, of course, it is density mass per volume. So, significant the first term is that time rate of change of mass per unit volume. Okay. Next, the second term, the first two lines here, net rate of flow of mass out by convection is same as integral balance. Once again, here it is per unit volume. Okay. So, significance is same as that of integral balance, but now they are on a per unit volume basis. So, how do you imagine? Remember, we had the control volume and then we said we are shrinking it to a point and then the small cuboidal volume here. So, per unit volume of that region, what is the rate of change of mass? Per unit volume of that region, what is the net mass flow leaving by convection? That is the significance. Okay. So, per unit volume to imagine, you should imagine a very, very small control volume, cuboidal control volume. Per unit volume, what is the time rate of change of mass, and then of course, and then net rate of flow of mass out by convection. Okay. And remember, all the terms in the differential mass balance equation are per unit volume basis. This is also universal. Whenever we are going to write differential balance equations, they are per unit volume basis. Okay. Now, what are the other names for this differential total mass balance equation? Okay. Because we consider a control volume and then shrink it to a point, it is also called as point form of mass balance equation. This you may not come across very frequently, but it is very obvious the way in which you have done. It is also called as point form of mass balance equation. Of course, we have been repeating it saying differential form of mass balance equation. The most popular name is this continuity equation. Okay. Continuity equation, the most popular name. So, all these mean the same, convey the same meaning. They all tell about mass balance in a small region under a steady state, unsteady state condition. Three different names, differential total mass balance, point form of total mass balance and the continuity equation. And you will come across the word continuity equation mostly always, I would say. Okay. Now, let us simplify this and consider two special cases. One is steady compressible flow. Moment it is steady, there is no transient term. Okay. So, the dou rho by dou t will not be present. You will have only this term, the divergence del dot rho v term, or if you expand it, you will have only the net rate of mass flow out term alone will be present. Okay. What is the example for this? You can consider, for example, flow of air in a duct. For our case, it's a rectangular duct at a relatively high velocity, not very low velocity. It's applicable for low velocity also, but if air is flowing at a high velocity, you will have to consider this form of the mass balance equation under steady state condition. Now, for incompressible flow, what are the examples we can take? First case is, first let us simplify this and then I will explain. Incompressible flow, the density is not a function of time or space. So, what happens? This derivative vanishes not because it is steady state, just because density is a constant value. Let us say water is flowing, then the density is, let us say, 1000, because it is not a function of time, this term vanishes. So, that should be kept in mind. Dou rho by dou t vanishes now, not because it is steady state flow, because it is incompressible, the density is just a constant value, hence dou rho by dou t vanishes. And then, because density is a constant, I can take out the density of all the derivative terms, and so that will also, that term rho also will not appear in the equation, and the differential equation becomes much simpler, just tells you dou v x by dou x plus dou v by dou y plus dou v z by dou z, or divergence of v is equal to 0. I will repeat the second part. We are considering incompressible flow. Now, I can give you examples. First example, as I told you, is flow of water, constant density. Rho is not a function of time, as a function of space also. So, first term does not contribute, rho can be taken out of the second term. Other example where this equation is valid is that flow of air at low velocities. Water is almost incompressible, certainly you can use this. Air is of course compressible, it is a gas, it is compressible, but if air is flowing at low velocities, then this equation is valid, and that is why I use the word here incompressible flow. So, when you say incompressible flow, two categories are considered. One is flow of incompressible fluid itself, which is water for example. Other is flow of a compressible fluid like air, but at low velocities. So, to if you want to summarize the application, suppose if it is flow of water, you use this equation, the second simplified equation. Flow of air at low velocities, once again use the simplified equation. But if air is flowing at high velocities, then you have to use this equation, which is a more general form. Also like to mention, this simplified form of incompressible flow is applicable both for steady state and unsteady state, because dou rho by dou t vanished because density being constant. Okay. Later on in the course, we will see another meaning of incompressible flow. Until then, we will stick on to this particular meaning. We will have a very nice physical representation of what we mean by incompressible flow, which will result in, of course, the same equation, but let us stick on to this right now.